Welcome back, students of class 3 to your science class. Today I will teach you a new chapter. You know that we have already started the chapter, so I will continue with the rest of the portion of the chapter. So let us write down here, this is chapter number 4, soil. Okay. Let me open this one, open the chapter, chapter number 3, soil. Today we are going to divide, we are going to do from page number 24. Okay. First of all, let me do it there, one MCQ is there on page number 24, let us solve it, MCQ. Okay. Number 1, tick the correct answers. Number 1, the uppermost layer of the earth is called water, soil, stone. It is soil. Number 2, roots of plants go into the soil to get water, minerals, water and minerals. It is water and minerals. Now I will explain this, what does soil contain. We will continue from there today. What does soil contain? Okay, let us see. Soil contains stones, that is gravel, sand, clay and humus. Take some garden soil. This is one of your activity. You can perform this activity at your home. See what you have to do in this activity. Take some garden soil. Put the soil in a glass jar. Fill the jar 3/4 with water. Cover it with a lid and shake it well. Leave it undisturbed. After some time, we observe different layers in the jar. At the bottom of the jar, we see a layer of small stones called gravel. It is the heaviest layer. Above the layer of gravel, we find a layer of sand containing larger particles. Above the sand, we find clay that contains fine particles. See, you can see everything in this picture given here. That picture, the water, and they are performing the activity in a glass jar. See, the glass jar is filled of water and there the different layers are formed. Okay, so after above the sand, we find clay that contains fine particles. The water above the layer of clay is not clear. Dead leaves, twigs and remains of dead insects float on the water. This is dark brown in color and is called humus. It makes the soil fertile. So this is the layer of different layers of the soil. So what you have to do, you have to take a handful of soil, then you have to take one glass jar, you have to fill it with water, 3/4 of the water with water, then you have to cover the jar with a lid, then you will put the soil inside the glass jar containing the water, then you have to shake it well. After you have to leave it undisturbed for some time. Then after some time, is after 20 minutes or 30 minutes probably, you will see different layers have been formed. At the bottom of the jar, you will see a layer of small stone, that is gravel. It is the heaviest layer. Above the layer of gravel, we find a layer of sand containing larger particles. Above the sand, we find clay that contains fine particles. The water above the layer of clay is not clear. Obviously, it is not, it will not be clear. Dead leaves, twigs and remains of dead insects float on the water. This is dark brown in color and is called humus. It makes the soil fertile. So, at the topmost part of the layer, it is the humus, means it contains dead leaves, twigs and remains of dead insects insects. This shows that soil contains stones, sand, clay and humus. So students, you can perform this activity at home. You can see this one performing this activity at home. You will see the different layers. And one homework I will give you, that you have to draw that glass jar showing the different layers of the soil. So that's all today, students. We will see you in the next class with the next portion of the chapter. So thank you, everyone.